Our next caller is Joanna from Florida.
Hi, Joanna. How can we help you?
I'm hoping you guys can help me out with my current routine because I'm going to be 50 next month. And as everybody says, things have changed. So I've been working out about 10 years and lifting a lot of weights, trying to build muscle because I know that that is something that is going to rapidly dissipate if I don't. But I'm just not progressing. The fatigue is a real issue. I have these great plans of how I'm going to work out. And then I guess it's changes in hormones, aging. I don't really know, but I'm trying to be on top of everything from circadian rhythm to nutrition to sleep to all the things. And what's the best way to go about all of this? I have a job that I have to sit at like right this minute for 8 hours a day and a 45-minute commute on either end. So I'm like obsessive about trying to get my workout in the mornings before I even get here, because when I get home, I am dead. So
I'm looking up at your question that you had sent in, and it says that boot camps and body pump. Is that how you've maintained your fitness up until this point?
Yeah. About, I've been working out at home for probably 8 years.
Okay. That's usually okay. And you're also saying that you're again in the same question that Adam's pointing to, that you feel fried after your workouts.
Well, I try to go hard enough to make a difference. I mean, I'm not going to mess around. I want to make sure that it's progressing as much as possible.
But it's not. So this is what I want you to consider, because I think oftentimes, especially those of us who are, you know, high achievers, or we like to, you know, accomplish things through grit and effort, is we tend to either lie to ourselves or ignore the signals. Whatever you're doing is too much. So it really doesn't matter what you're doing. It's just too much. Obviously, your body's telling you the right dose is going to get your body to progress. More than that, it's not going to happen. And you can't push through that. There's no way of adding even more to too much to make it work. It just makes things even worse.
I'm also going to go out on a limb and just say that your body is probably adapted to that type of training. I'm assuming if you're into the body pump and boot camp type of training, it's probably high paced, low rest periods, kind of, you know, getting a pump and a sweat versus strict sets of like four or five reps and then rest periods for a minute and a half to 3 minutes. Is that right?
Yeah.
So
I mean, I found that, I can't even do like high intensity training for more than about 15 minutes. Some of them are longer, and I'm just like, that's ridiculous.
Yeah. MAPS anabolic all the way. Yeah. I would put you on MAPS anabolic, follow the program as it's laid out. You could do three foundational workouts a week, do some trigger sessions on the off days. Watch what happens. Watch what happens to your body. Now, you mentioned some about hormones and all that stuff. I don't think there's an issue there, but if you do think that there's a hormonal issue, you can get it checked out with our partners at mphormones.com, and they'll do a whole assessment with you and all that stuff. But I think the issue is your training is all wrong for your body.
Yeah.
And I would go MAPS anabolic straight all the way through, follow it as it's laid out, trust the programming. Within 3 weeks, you'll notice a difference. You'll feel like, oh, more energy, stronger. And then after about 60 days, you should start to see some visible
results. So long as you truly stick to it. So that I'm going to make sure, okay, when someone's trained this way, so one of the hardest things when I have a client like this that's trained similar to you is getting out of that mentality of like the workout needs to be this, it needs to be this, I'm sweating and I need to feel like I kicked ass. You don't need to feel like that. And it's also really hard to get someone like you to sit still and actually truly rest for 2 minutes before you go do your next set. You know, you would be the client who would always be telling me, I'm ready to go, Adam. I'm ready to go. Yeah,
feels like nothing.
Yeah. I'm ready. Next set. Can we do next set? And I'm constantly going, relax. You're doing good. We're resting. We're resting right now. We're going to wait. You still got another 30, 45 seconds before I want you to do your next set. And that's really hard to do for someone who has trained a particular way for so long. So probably the biggest challenge of MAPS anabolic for you won't be so much the exercise programming in it, but more so the mentality that you need to now have going into these workouts for them to be truly effective. Do not look at them as, oh, I want to crush these and get through these. That's not the objective here. Follow the blueprints. Give yourself the long rest periods in between. Try and get stronger. I want each set, I want to be stronger. It's not about how much I'm sweating. It's not how much my body is burning. It's all about following the program the way it's laid out.
Think about it this way, Joanna. When you're telling your body to build strength and build muscle, okay, think of all the hormones associated with adding muscle, right? So you're going to get more youthful levels of hormones as a result of this. Now, if you continue down the path that you've been going on, which is boot camp style workouts, body pump, obviously frying your CNS, you're probably telling your body to not build muscle. And you, in fact, you might be telling your body to start to lose muscle. Now, think of the hormones associated with that process, right? Elevated cortisol, growth hormone, not youthful, an imbalance between estrogen and progesterone. I wouldn't be surprised if you noticed changes, not just in energy, but also in libido. You might also notice more cravings as your body is trying to get more sugar in your body to, you know, keep you alive, essentially. So am I accurate? Am I hitting all the points here?
Yeah. I mean, that's why I thought, like, I don't know another source to go to, because like I study this constantly. Like, what am I doing wrong? Because I'm try my best to do every little thing that is going to give me some positive outcomes. So
are you
saying not working out every day?
Oh yeah.
Oh, 2 to 3 days a week. That is it.
Now you can walk every day. You can do mobility every day. You want to do yoga every day. That's totally fine. Strength train 2 or 3 days a week. That's it.
Yeah. Something here too to consider as you switch this up and focus a little more on strength training, and you're sitting so much and you know you're in your commute and your muscles are gonna feel like they're locking up and tight. You wanna really reinforce good posture. So to establish a good ritual to address those things like the hip flexors, you know, your shoulders protracting, you know, that's something especially if you can find time throughout the day and get up out of your chair and kind of go against the wall. And something I recommend, we have one of the webinars, if you haven't checked out yet, you know, the Prime webinar, where we kind of go into some of those easy things to do just against a wall to reinforce good posture and to really attack those so you don't start locking up and having issues as you start actually like focusing a little bit more on lifting weights and strength training.
Yeah, it's mapsprimewebinar.com. Do you have MAPS Anabolic, by the way?
No, I don't.
All right, we're gonna send that right over to you, and just follow that to a T. On the other days, you can walk, do yoga, work on mobility, and here's what you'll experience. Okay, I'm gonna be, you know, Nostradamus right now, I'll be Salstradamus. Here's what you're gonna feel. And initially, when you follow
that ego barely fits in the door.
Yeah, I know. What are you gonna do?
Einstein.
I'm making the prediction. Yes. If I'm wrong, you can DM me, okay? But here's what you'll notice. Okay. The first week, you're going to be like, this is not enough. This doesn't feel like enough. I feel like I'm not doing enough working out. What's going on? By week two, you should notice an increase in your libido. That'll happen by week two. By week three, you'll start to get better sleep. By the fourth week, you'll start to see a difference in the mirror. And then after, you'll start to think to yourself, I'm getting leaner. This is very strange. I feel like I'm burning less calories. Why am I getting leaner? That's how you're going to feel when you start to train your body properly.
I would like to add one more recommendation to you. I would love to see you follow MAPS Anabolic. And then because you were probably used to training every day, and I never like to break that from a client. If I've had a client who has disciplined themselves to exercise and do things to take care of their body on a daily basis, I want to switch their focus, right? So strength training 3 days a week, and then your other 3 to 4 days that you would normally be weight training or doing boot camp stuff, I want you to go for a walk. And on your walk, I would love for you to listen to the Resistance Training Revolution, the book that Sal just wrote. This book and the content that is in this book is literally will speak to you. And I just think it would be very therapeutic. It would be good for you to listen to that while you go for a nice walk. Go for a walk on the other days that you're not doing the resistance training and listen to the book.
Okay.
That's my recommendation.
All right. Thanks for calling in, Joanna. We'll send you MAPS
and a ball. Thank you, guys.
Yep.
I appreciate you. You're making my commute bearable. So thank you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Awesome.
All right.
You know this highlights? She listens to the podcast regularly. it's taken her this long to call or even consider changing what she was doing. That's how hard it is to break.
No, that's why, and that's why
typical client. Yeah,
100%. Yeah. She is like, she's spot on to normal.
She's like 70% of the people I trained. Right there.
Yeah, I know. When I feel sometimes when we talk to these people on the Q&A like this, I always feel bad because I feel like they think that we're kind of like hammering them. But it's like, dude, you are literally so normal.
Like, these are the same conversations we've had like over the years, like every single time. So it's very typical.
And the hardest part of this will not be her discipline to be consistent or her ability to bring intensity to the workout. It will literally be to follow the programming, to back off of all the intense training when she feels like, oh my God, I can do more, to not do more, because this is the client who would finish her workout with you and then you'd see her out in the gym floor an hour later still doing more exercises after you train.
I can't tell you how many times I kick people out of the gym. I used to do that. I'd see a client like, what are you doing over here?
I really hope that she gets the book and listens to the book, because I feel like what you wrote in Resistance Training Revolution really speaks to a client like this, and I think that it can be life-changing. I really do, especially someone like her who's got the discipline, and she's in pretty damn good shape, at least what it looked like from where I was sitting. So, I mean, she's not like she's got a long way to go somewhere. She just needs to shift her mindset.